And if I put the lid back down, you can see that the relative humidity almost instantly rises again. Oh, hi. This episode, I'm going to be proving that PLA gets wet along with sharing some other observations that I found on the way. Let's get started. The filament dryer in this episode has been provided free of charge by Sovol. The terms of the exchange are on screen now. So thank you, Sovol, for providing this and enabling me to do a lot of what's in this video. I wasn't going to touch the idea of wet filament with a barge pole. In fact, I've actually done this before. Well, I've actually done videos about moisture before, but very few people have watched them, which is fine, I guess. But to get to the point, here's some background. I did not believe that PLA filament can get wet. Why? Well, I've never suffered from any moisture-related issues personally, so of course it didn't make sense to me for PLA to be able to absorb water from my environment. Maybe in some faraway lands where there's weird birds? Might be a problem, but no, not here in sunny, dry England. But then I started messing around with this dryer, and you might be wondering at this point, why on earth are you reviewing a dryer if you don't believe in wet filament? Well, the short answer is that I do believe that moisture affects some filaments, like this PVA here, which is notorious for being hygroscopic. So I needed a way to dry this, and I thought, fine, you know, we'll be able to test it with this filament. Anyway, the problem is, well, watch. I put this reel of PLA that's been open for a while into the dryer while the dryer is already heated up, and I close it, and the air inside gets, wait for it, more moist. To understand what's going on, we need to take a step back and look a bit at the theory. I have been advised by at least three separate people that I absolutely shouldn't open this can of worms, but you know how it is, I don't listen. I'll plow through this as quickly as possible though, so that you don't notice the mistakes that I'm making in explaining. Relative humidity is a percentage value representing a proportion of the amount of humidity that air can hold. This changes with temperature and pressure, but we'll ignore the second one because it's convenient to do so. Hotter air can hold a lot more moisture. Here's a graph that proves it. I didn't draw this, this is from an important science book. But anyway, that means that the volume of air that's sealed inside a closed container, when heated up, if you're measuring relative humidity, that reading will go down. Why? Well, pay attention, I literally just explained that. But the amount of water in that container in grams per meter cube doesn't change at all, but raising the temperature reduces the relative humidity because the air is capable of holding more because it's hotter. Now this Sovol dry box is different to every other dry box that I've seen before because they've put a gasket around the lid and there's even airtight thingies on the top and back. What this means is that I can do exactly that experiment that I just mentioned and I can plot a graph and here it is. And luckily the relative humidity does indeed go down as the box of air heats up. If I bothered to leave this to cool down again, it would go the other way and return back to what it was originally, and I'd be able to see how airtight the box is, I suppose, but I'm on a deadline, so let's not. But because it is a sealed container, well, as you saw in the beginning, I can put a reel of filament in, and if it's already up to temperature, I can nearly instantly tell you if there's moisture in that reel. You could do this over and over again. You can put filament in, close it, watch the values go up, open it, watch them go down again. The moisture is not appearing from another dimension, it's from the filament. Anyway, we have more tests. You see, what I did before with heating up the empty box and making a graph is now suddenly useful because I can do the same thing with a reel of wet filament or a reel of suspected wet filament, and I can look at the difference. It's important to note that I was doing these experiments during a relative heat wave here in the UK, which was totally messing with my initial conditions. So ignore the start temperature and the gaps in the chart. Humidity varies a lot throughout the day as well, as I've discovered, so it is nearly impossible, even if you run these experiments concurrently, it's nearly impossible to start with the same values. But that's okay, that's not what I was looking for. What I was looking for was new moisture appearing at a certain point while I was heating up the chamber. And as a simple demonstration, if you do this with silica gel, it's pretty obvious. You get actual condensation. Silica gel is insanely good at adsorbing, with a D, let's not go into that, so much so that it literally lets out steam when you heat it up. And yeah, by the way, storing silica gel in a box with wet filament does actually dry the filament. I don't really want to get into that and make the video 10 minutes long, but moving on. I thought I'd do some measurements of temperature versus humidity for a few reels of filament, and I found some surprising things. Surprising to me at least, because I didn't think moisture was a thing. If I show you the full graph for all the filaments I tested before I literally ran out of open reels, they nearly all have this tiny flick up at the end, and you could see that some of them diverge when they get over 40 degrees C from the baseline. To be clear as to what we're looking at here, the relative humidity at some point when the air around the filament heats up, not the filament itself, because obviously that's going to be lagged, the relative humidity actually goes up. There's no way that this is really possible for a closed system, a box of air that we've got that's sealed. So we didn't see it on the baseline, obviously. All of these reels of filament are expelling moisture into the air. Anyway, along with these results, I do want to address a couple of important things. Firstly, this is not a good way to dry filament. As I showed you earlier, you can open and close the door and keep repeating this process. This is because you're in a closed system. You need convection to actually remove the moist air and give you some more drier air so that you can continue to remove more moisture. If you imagine, it's kind of like a conveyor belt removing the moisture. The dryer actually has a fan in the back, which is really cool. They actually tell you here to prop the lid open when drying. If you have a filament dryer that mostly seals and you're not doing this, then all you're doing really is warming up your filament. Once your filament is dry, seal the box and it keeps dry. You can even put some desiccant in after you've dried it to kind of deal with any tiny leaks or leftover humidity. And the second thing I wanted to address was raised by one of my Patreon patrons, and they are absolutely right. The diagnostic process of sealing filament into a warm, sealed small space and monitoring the humidity does not tell you how much moisture that filament has. To do that, you would need to use much more sophisticated methods. Something else I didn't really look into was the effect that dry filament has on the printing. A really good example of this, though, can be found on Filament Stories channel, which I've put a link to in the description. It's a really good channel, check it out. I did myself a brief test, also with one very old reel of PLA, and I was actually able, surprisingly, because I didn't think that this reel was misbehaving, but I was able to reproduce a definite difference. So what is the takeaway here then? What's to learn from this? Well, firstly, I've totally changed my stance on storing and drying filament. Previously, I would have told you to protect from dust, but to totally ignore moisture. Now though, I would advise you to store all your filament, regardless of what material it is, in sealed bags with desiccant. Secondly, I think it's worth considering that nothing is really dry or wet. As we've kind of seen from the evidence, I feel like you can always get more moisture out of a reel of filament, and I also feel like there will be an acceptable level in the filament of moisture. I'm inclined to believe that a significant amount of moisture is actually not really noticeable in filament until you get beyond that point. I think it's important to think, well, it's a scale, not a binary value. And finally, I think there's huge merit in owning a dry box, or at least a way to dry filament. I polled you all before I made this video, and the bulk of you, as you can see on screen, either had or were interested in a dry box. I might do another poll after this video and see if that changes. That would be quite interesting. But I do think that drying filament before printing or before putting away is definitely worth considering. Of course, you absolutely don't have to buy a dry box like the Sovol one that I have here. You can achieve the same with any heated volume. In fact, you can dry filament on your printer bed if you want. So that's it. Of course, in making this video, I had to ignore or simplify a lot of the complicated stuff to do with this topic, and I do know that I've done that, for better or worse, but hopefully it has been of some use. Let me know in the comments whether any of this has changed your mind on how to store filament, or if you think I'm right or wrong. As usual, links or corrections, because no doubt there will be some for this video, they will be below in the description. I've got a couple of really good videos in the pipeline that I'm keeping a tighter lid on than this dry box has. Sorry. So make sure you are subscribed, and I will see you next time.